What this is leading to here is, I know this is supposed to be a funny deal I'm supposed to be saying up here, and plenty tough for me, but he says, kid, he says, I'm going to take care of you. He says, I'm gonna send you up to Seattle and let you race with the big guys. I'm going to pay you good, going to give you $750. He says, make four runs. I get tickets for my crew. He said, sure, everything you need. Just go on in there and just run good for me. And I went in there and I ran. I don't know how good it was, but I ran. And he took care of me, and I'm in the same boat again. Here I am up here making speeches with people I've never seen before. I'm in trouble again, but it's kind of funny. I walked through that door tonight, and I looked out there, and I said, I can't even believe this deal. I see all these superstars. I see Prudhomme. I see Beadle. I see McEwen and Lombardo, Paisano, and I said, oh, man, this must be heaven. And Donor walks through the door, and I said, oh, shit, blew this deal. So anyway, You gotta say nice things about the man, because I mean, he sits up there all week long in that tower, and he just thinks up things to say about us. And I mean, he said a lot of good things to me, like years ago, like, son, why don't you take your car fishing, because it don't belong out here. And you know, it's kind of funny, but it when a guy tells you, he says, I want you to take your car up here to Seattle. He says, I want to make these runs at Portland, Seattle. He says, I'm going to put you in the paper. He says, I'm going to make you a star. And, you know, you get all pumped up, and you leave your job on Friday night, and the two guys that are with you, you're all fixing to go out and get drunk, and they've spent their wife's checks buying you fuel to run his race. And none of us can go home, and you just ride along there listening for that radio ad to come up any minute. So hear him say your name, and slides right through it, never mentioned, Jim. Just breaks your heart. And call him up and said, well, you know, I've had that villain a few times. And he told me, he says, I had you on five or six stations, kid. He says, I'm going to talk big about you. And I stood up there, and I never heard it. And all these years, I got a sponsor stepped up and paid a little money, so they're mentioning me every now and then. So, and many more, that's exactly it. But anyway, everyone's been up here kind of knocking him, and he's taken care of me over the years, and I really
foreign phrase.
Yeah, I really got no complaints, and I got a lot of complaints. You want to hear them? I'll be out in the lobby later. I'll tell you about it. But it's kind of a funny thing, but you know, the man says you got to have respect for him, because like I say, he's the only one on the radio, and you tell your mother, you say, you listen it. At 10 o'clock and 8 o'clock and 2 o'clock and 4 o'clock, and he will come on and he will mention my name. And your mother calls you and says, hey, he didn't mention your name. Okay, well, he will. It's coming. Calls you up and he says, okay, Forrest. He says, you hit Seattle. He says, I'm gonna give you that big cash. I'm going to give you $800. Roll in there and put on a good show for the folks. And I said, yes, sir, I will. And you get up there, you stay on the road for 3 days, and you ain't slept, and your crew's all tired, and your girlfriend's mad at you, and you roll into town, and he gives you $800. That's a raise I got. And that's 800 total. Rolled in there, slung a rod out of my motor, set my car on fire, walked out there and said, got to cut you $50 for the grease sweep you put on the track. Can't even believe this stuff.